Carrie from Sesame Street, and I'm looking for the word on the street. What's the word on the street?
Appetite.
What does the word appetite mean?
When you're really craving something.
What do you have an appetite for?
Chicken.
Carrot.
Carrots?
I like carrots.
I like carrots, too, because they're orange like me.
You have any appetites for non-food things?
How about movies?
Soccer.
Roller coaster.
You got an appetite for roller coasters. Keep listening for the word appetite today on Sesame Street.
Appetite.
That's the word on the street.
My new magic trick!
Yeah!
excuse me. I got a phone call. Hello? Oh, Mommy! Yes, Mommy. Not yet, Mommy. Okay, Mommy. All right, Mommy. Bye, Mommy. Guess who that was?
Abby's Mommy.
What? How did you know? Anyway, she reminded me that I gotta take these books back to the library before it closes. So, I'll see you later, Elmo.
Bye, Abby. Abby, you forgot. Her wand. Well, Elmo will just hang on to it until Abby gets back. Elmo wonders if Elmo could make magic with this wand. Let's try. Abracadabra! Oh, well. Well, it makes for a good back scratcher. or Elmo can pretend to be a conductor. Music, music, music! What was that? What's Elmo done? Where is that music coming from? Wait, Elmo's singing. Why is Elmo singing? Give it another try. Music, music, music!
Gordon, what a move!
Thanks, Bob.
Now I can do this.
Nice job.
Elmo, can you magic now? This is the greatest thing! By waving Abby's wand around, Elmo makes people sing.
Pass the ball to me.
Good block.
I'm open over here.
Nice shot.
Can't stop singing.
Can't stop singing.
This is amazing. It's so much fun. Elmo can make music come from anyone. Watch. Music, music, music.
I think my watch is slow.
Nice rock.
Ow, I stubbed my toe.
Walk, walk.
Come on, take the shot.
Too late.
I think you've got me now.
Checkmate.
And singing is so much fun. It makes you feel so good. Now Elmo can spread that joy to all the neighborhood.
Can't stop singing. Can't stop singing now. singing, can't stop singing.
Elmo loves when everyone sings along. Now let's see who else could use a song. Come on!
Alan, my good man?
Hey, baby bear. What can I get you?
Well...
Music, music, music!
There's a certain type of food that I love to eat. It's mushy and smooth and it's totally sweet.
I think I know what you're trying to say. You want this special kind of food to start your day.
I'm talking porridge, 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 yummy, yummy porridge.
I knew it.
Porridge, 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 yummy, yummy porridge. I love to eat it morning, noon, and night time.
So here's some fresh porridge to start your day right.
Ooh, porridge.
Sing almost anywhere. But what would happen if Elmo would try to wave this wand up really high?
It's too hot! It's too hot!
Oh, say it's not!
It's too hot! It's too hot!
Sorry, baby bear, straight out of the pot. It's hot, but I will get you some porridge that's not.
Ow! That's hot!
Goes up high, the music goes high too. Now Elmo wonders how the music would go if Elmo waved the wand down really low.
Oh, it's too cold. It's too cold.
Oh, no.
It's too cold. It's too cold.
Sorry again. I guess this porridge is old. Let's try for something that's not too hot and not too cold.
Oh, it's cold. Just white, quite a delight.
The porridge is perfect, party delight. I hope you brought your appetite.
We're talking porridge, yummy, yummy porridge.
I knew it.
Porridge, yummy, yummy porridge. Porridge, yummy, yummy porridge. Porridge, yummy, yummy porridge.
That was fun making the music go. Way up high and way down low. Let's see what else that Elmo can do to make some music louder and softer too.
Hey, Leela.
Hey, what's wrong?
Well, check this out. It's a mustard stain. It's on my favorite shirt.
Oh. Well, how can I help you?
Music, music, music.
Well, you know you have to save my
shirt.
Get that stain out of my
shirt.
Somehow clean up my
shirt.
Come on now. Come on now, please now won't you say you can? Please now won't you say,
yeah.
So you can.
I'll get it out right now.
Come on now,
sure.
Come on now,
sure.
Take it easy,
sure.
Take it easy,
sure.
Take it easy.
Let's see how the music will play.
A tiny bit softer now. You got it out now. Got the stain out right now. I want a shot now. That's all about now.
Soft and high and low.
Yummy, yummy,
porridge,
yummy.
Can you hear my shop singing? Can you hear my shop singing? Can you hear my shop singing?
What happened? Did you do a singing spell with my wand?
Yes, and it's a mess.
Here, don't worry. I know just what to do. Music, music, music! Stop! Huh? Oh! It worked!
Wait, Emma's talking again! Yay!
What was that all about?
Yeah, why couldn't we stop singing?
I know it!
Magic with Abby's wand. And Emma didn't mean for it to get out of control. Emma just wanted to hear everybody sing.
Well, we sang, all right. And sang, and sang,
and sang.
Yeah, but when everybody sings all at once, then you can't hear anybody sing.
Oh, Elmo, the next time you want to hear people sing, you don't have to use magic. You can just sing yourself.
Huh? Well, what does Lila mean?
Listen.
Sometimes if you sing a song, it doesn't take so very long till someone else joins in and sings it too.
Then more people hear the song and join in too, and before long everybody's singing with you.
And that's music. Oh,
music can reach a place.
Reach a place.
Deep inside.
Deep inside.
When you hear a song,
even though we cannot hide,
he urges you sing along, you can't be denied.
Cause we all have music deep inside. There's a music. Oh, music. If you Just start
To sing
A song.
Then others
Will start
To sing along. You'll reach a place Deep inside you hear a song.
Here is all
we cannot hide.
The urge
to sing along, you can't be denied.
Cause
we all have music deep inside.
Hey everybody, I'm Reggie. I'm here to tell you about the word appetite. Now the word appetite means a strong want for something, like food. I have an appetite for some food right now, so I'm gonna have my lunch.
Oh, Reggie, are you gonna eat that submarine sandwich?
Well, I was thinking about it. Why?
Cause I really, really want a submarine sandwich.
So what you're saying is you have an appetite for a submarine sandwich.
Oh, yeah!
Wow, he's got some appetite. Well, at least I still have my apple.
Oh, Reggie, I need this apple. I want this apple. I gotta have this apple.
Sounds like she has an appetite for apples.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, well, there you have it. That's the word.
Appetite.
Can you move your hands like wings? Like this. Great! You're all ready for flying fairy school. But first, it's time for the letter M. That's why we're gonna play Bring Out Your M. What sound does the letter M make? That's good. Now, come on. Let's find some things that start with the letter M. Bring out your M! Bring out your M! Do you have anything that starts with the letter M?
Mustache.
Mustache! Yeah. Mustache starts with M! Bring out your M!
Money starts with M.
Money does start with M.
Okay.
Money!
Do you have anything here that maybe begins with the letter M?
Mom.
That's right! Mom begins with the letter M! Do you have anything that starts with the letter M? Ooh, I see something on you that starts with M. It's on your face, it's filled with teeth, and you eat with it. Know what it is? Yeah, mouth. Mouth begins with M. Magnificent. Now come on, let's see more of the letter M.
M. Music. M. Music. M. Music. M. Music. Music.
Coming up next is
Abby's Flying Fairy School.
Look up high in the sky. It's a school. It can fly.
Let's all hurry to the Flying Fairy School. Grab your wand. Bring your wings. We will learn.
Welcome to Flying Fairy School. Today's the day you earn your wings. Your fairy godmother wings, that is. Do you have your wands ready? If not, just use your finger, because it's time for the Cinderella Challenge!
Oh, no. I don't know anything about being a fairy godmother.
Oh, don't worry, Donegan. I'll help you. After all, my mommy is the fairy godmother.
All right, class. First, we have to pick someone to be our Cinderella.
Well, Cinderella is a girl, and Abby is a girl. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge.
Oh, come on. Cinderella doesn't get to do any magic.
Now, there's only one fair way to decide who our Cinderella will be.
Eeny, meeny, miny, ming, catch a fairy by the wing if it hollers, say.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to hurt you. I should have realized that fairy wings are very delicate. Then let go of the wing and sing,
eeny, meeny, miny, ming.
Huh? You will be playing Cinderella.
Me? Oh, but I want to do the magic.
I'm sorry, dear, but eeny, meeny is legally binding. You have to be our Cinderella for the day.
Aww.
Now, there are four magical parts to the Cinderella challenge. First, you must magically give Cinderella a beautiful gown. Second, you have to give Cinderella beautiful glass slippers. Third, you must change a pumpkin into something Cinderella can ride to the ball in. And last but not least, in order to earn your wings, you must get Cinderella to the ball by the time the fairy timer reaches 12. Now, let the Cinderella challenge begin!
Oh, the fairy timer's moving. What do we do?
First, we gotta get Blog a gown, remember?
Aw, can't I just wear a pantsuit?
Sorry, Blog, it must be a gown.
A gown, no problem. We just need a magic rhyme.
Oh, I'm not very good at rhyming.
Don't worry, I am. Let's see, what rhymes with gown? Oh, I know. Gown, down.
Ah!
Oops, a little too dressed down. I'll try another rhyme. Gown, clown.
I can't let the prince see me dressed like this.
Oh, dear. Gown, gin, clown.
Help me! I jump right back and I kiss myself! Gown!
Well, it's not working, and Cinderella can't go to the ball in town without a gown!
Hey! That's another rhyme! And maybe you can't go to town without a fancy gown! Ooh! Let's try it! Gown to town! It worked! Blog's got a beautiful gown!
And it's surprisingly comfortable!
You've now completed the first part of the Cinderella Challenge!
Look at the fairy timer. It's already at 4.
Oh, then let's get to the second part of the challenge. We have to magically give Cinderella her glass slipper.
I can't work under this kind of pressure.
Don't worry, Donegan. My mommy does this all the time. We just have to wave our wands and say, fragile footwear.
Fragile footwear. Here are your shoes, Blog. No, I think that these are too small.
Maybe I'm retaining water.
Oops. Clean up in aisle one.
What are we gonna do? Blog's feet are so huge.
I prefer to think of them as big boned.
Maybe we just need to change the magic words to larger fragile footwear. Wave your wands.
Larger fragile footwear.
Oops. I think those are too large.
They're too heavy.
Clean up in aisle two. Looks like we could use some help. Spot! Oh, Spot! How do we make slippers that fit Blog?
Fetch, Spot, fetch!
I made it!
I'm gonna save this.
Let's twinkle think. Twinkle think, twinkle think. Oh, 12 might have something to do with the shoe. Oh, maybe 12 is the number of laces.
I'm not wearing lace-ups with a gown. That would be a fashion faux pas.
Oh, wait. Sizes. Shoe sizes are numbers.
Hey, yeah, maybe he's size 12. Let's try size 12 fragile footwear. One, ready?
Size 12 fragile footwear!
Ooh, I love the way these shoes make my calves look!
You did it! You completed the second part of the Cinderella Challenge!
Oh no! The fairy timer's already at 9!
Then let's hurry up and turn the pumpkin into a ride for Cinderella! Now where's that pumpkin?
Oh no! Niblet ate the pumpkin!
How are we gonna get Cinderella to the ball now?
Mrs. Sparklenose, does Cinderella's ride have to be made from a pumpkin?
Not at all! I love fairy improvisation! Go for it!
Oh, let's think! What else can we turn into a ride?
The least you can do for eating our pumpkin.
Boop, boop.
Oh, but I don't know how to turn a gerbil corn into a ride. Do you?
I'm not sure. I can try.
Well, hurry up! The timer's almost at 12.
Okay. Ride.
Boat! It's a boat!
But there's no water here! I need a royal hoopty with wheels.
Wait, try again, Gonagon.
Okay, wheels.
A tricycle?
Well, it does have wheels.
But I can't pedal in pumps. I'll go too slow.
Okay, got it. Fast.
A motorcycle.
Cool. And fast.
You completed the third part of the challenge.
Now we have to get Blob to the ball.
But the fairy timer's at 11.
Then let's ride.
Whoa. Careful, Blob.
I'm trying, but I don't even have a gerbil corn license. What? Now take us to the ball, please.
Well, I don't even know where the ball is or how to get there.
Well, I know how to get to a ball.
Like the ball in the story, but that'll work.
You did it!
You completed the Cinderella challenge.
Yeah! Oh, boy!
And it's all thanks to Gonagon.
Me?
Well, yeah. You're the one who figured out all the parts of the challenge.
I did, didn't I?
And that means fairy godmother wings for everyone.
It's almost time for Super Grover, but first, we're gonna find out about...
The number zero!
How many is zero?
None!
Oh yeah, it's none! Zero bicycles! Zero baseball gloves! Zero kids! Zero cards!
What are you drawing, Jada?
A zero.
Ooh, zero. Come on, let's see some more about the number zero.
There are zero sardine duds. There are zero sardine puffs. Zero sardine booty.
Hey, Mika, what's coming up next?
Super Grover!
Oh, boy!
He observes.
Oh, look! No! Oh, no!
He questions.
How about what?
Investigates.
What does this button do?
Super Grover 2.0. He shows up. In a world covered with ice and snow, one piece of ice is about to change these penguins' lives forever.
All right, penguins, dance time!
What's going on?
This giant block of ice is right in the middle of our dance floor.
What's with the strange music?
What's with the strange car?
What's with the strange dude?
I am not just any strange dude. I am a super strange dude. For I am Super Grover 2.0!
What seems to be the problem?
Well...
Wait! Do not tell me, for I will unleash my powers of observation. I cannot observe a thing with this giant block of ice in the way.
The giant ice block is the problem.
It is?
Yeah. We can't do our penguin dance routine because this giant block of ice is on our dance floor.
Oh, do not worry, my wee waddling compadres. For I, Super Grover 2.0, will unleash my power of investigation.
What's he going to do?
I wonder what would happen if I tickled the ice. Tickle, tickle, tickle. Goochie, goochie, goochie.
I wonder what would happen if you gave it a push.
Wait a minute.
Wait.
I wonder what would happen if I gave it a push.
That's what I said.
Behold, as I investigate with a push.
Ooh.
It's really not moving much.
This giant block of ice appears to be very big and heavy.
Oh.
Have no fear, little penguins. I shall just use a little more force.
Oh.
Oh, no, investigating could be so painful. Ouch.
We'll never dance again.
I am not giving up yet, my tuxedoed amigos. It is time to unleash the power of technology! I'm going to go get some tools to help me move the block of ice.
Hey!
What?
Check out the Super Grover Mobile.
What about it?
It's big and heavy, like the block of ice, but it moves.
Hey, yeah! Yeah, but what makes it move so easily?
Okay, I am back now.
Super Grover, maybe you should try wheels.
Nonsense! You cannot hit a block of ice with wheels to move it. But you can hit it with a sturdy metal golf club.
What? Oh, boy.
Four!
I wonder if we could move the ice out of the way if it had wheels.
Well, there's only one way to find out. Come on, birds! Everybody grab a wheel!
Wheel, 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 wheel.
Sis, boom, blah, 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 blah.
Okay, come on.
Okay.
You got it? Okay, here we go. Okay.
What are you penguins doing?
We're using the power of technology.
Oh, yeah. Can we borrow this technology? Thanks.
Okay,
bring it. I got it.
Yep.
Yeah. All right, penguins. Now let's try moving this block of ice.
Do not be silly. If a super guy like me cannot move that block of ice, there's no way four little penguins can do it. Ha! How about what? The little penguins are moving it? How are you moving that giant piece of ice?
Wheels!
Now come on, penguins, let's dance! Hit it!
Wing, 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 wing.
Well, my super work here is done. I will just drive away in the Super Grover Mobile. No. The Super Grover Mobile is not moving. Why is the Super Grover Mobile not moving?
And so our intrepid hero has discovered that if wheels can help move the Super Grover Mobile, they can make it easier to move other heavy things.
That is right. I did learn that, didn't I? Anybody got any wheels?
I can't wait for Elmo's World. But right now, let me show you backward and forward. Right now? Which way am I going now?
Backward!
Which way am I going now?
Forward!
Right! Let's keep moving forward!
Ouch!
Elmo's World is on the way.
to do the Elmo slide. Everybody tap your arms. Here we go now. Tap, 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 tap your arms. 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 Slide to the front. Slide to the back. Slide to the side. Slide to the other side. Jump one time.
Fast as I can.
That's not fast. That's not fast, Tortoise. That's slow.
What's your rush? Got a train to catch?
But I'm almost thinking about fast. And slow. And slow too. Ooh. What's that, Dorothy? Oh, okay. Dorothy has a question. How do you dance fast? Oh, good question, Dorothy. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Faster, Shade. Just a shade, please. Oh, thank you, Shade. Hi, Mr. Noodle. Hi. Oh, Elmo likes Mr. Noodle's hat. That's really cool. Oh, Mr. Noodle? Yeah. Dorothy has a question. Would you like to hear it? Okay. How do you dance fast, Mr. Noodle? Fast.
Yeah, show us fast. Okay, here he goes.
Wait, that's not fast.
That's slow dancing.
Nice dancing, but that's not fast.
That's slow.
Yep, you heard right.
Try again, Mr. Noodle.
You can do it.
Think fast.
A little better.
It's a little faster than the first one.
But it's not really fast.
That's not fast enough.
Show us fast, Mr. Noodle.
Okay, Mr. Noodle.
Go for it.
There he goes with the hat thing again.
Yay!
That's it, Mr. Noodle! Yay!
Nope, that's dancing fast.
Mr. Noodle's dancing as fast as he can!
Can you go faster?
Keep doing it! Faster!
Wow, look at him go! He's moving!
Faster!
Even faster!
Boy, Mr. Noodle sure is fast on his feet. What's that, Dorothy? Okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you dance fast?
This is how I dance fast, Dorothy. I move my feet really fast.
Dorothy, I dance fast like this. I move my arms and legs as fast as I can.
Oh, thanks, everybody. Oh, and thank you, Dorothy. Now, Elmo will ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. Hello, hello. Baby, how do you dance fast?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, thank you, baby. Kiss, kiss, kisses. Oh, and thank you, Mommy.
Sure.
Baby. Oh, and now Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many racehorses are going fast? Let's count them and see. Oh, racehorses.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Oh, 14 fast racehorses. Oh, and one very slow snail. Boy, he's going at a snail's pace. Oh, fast thinking, snail. And great counting, everybody. That makes Elmo wonder. What can go fast and slow? Let's find out. Oh, Troy. Boy, Troy is as slow as molasses. Can ice skates go fast and slow?
No, but an ice skater can.
Fast! Slow! Can you eat ice cream fast and slow?
Yes!
Slow down! You'll get a tummy ache! Now that's much better! Can a worm go fast and slow?
It goes slow.
Slimy in his race car. Go, Slimy, go! Boy, that worm can put the pedal to the metal. Thanks, Troy. Boy, that's one fast
Elmo has mail.
Worm.
Elmo has mail.
Hey, everything's happening so fast.
Elmo has mail.
Not so
Elmo
fast,
has
computer.
Mail.
Elmo wants his email.
Elmo has mail.
Not so slow, computer. Elmo wants his email.
Elmo has
a fast one. Gotcha. Oh, boy. Elmo got email from his friends, Ingrid and Humphrey, Natasha's mommy and dad.
Our little Natasha wants to show you how fast she can crawl. Yeah, Natasha, crawl fast for Elmo.
Go ahead, crawl fast, honey lamb.
Natasha, that is not fast.
No, I believe that is slow.
Slow? Ingrid, our Natashiwashi is showing Elmo how slow she can crawl.
Oh, isn't that just the slowest crawling you've ever seen, Elmo?
And the fastest, too.
Thanks, computer. Boy, Natasha is a very fast baby, isn't she? Oh, and computer's fast, too. Bye, computer. Boy, Elmo's friend, Diana, wanted to skate fast, but it wasn't easy. She told Elmo all about it.
One day, my sister gave her old skates. I couldn't wait to try them out. My sister's a really good skater. She can skate really fast. I put on all of my protective pads and my helmet. Only I didn't know how to skate. My sister said that she would teach me. I wanted to skate fast too. But my sister told me to take it slow. That's how you learn. So I moved my feet very slowly. I didn't get too far. But I got up and tried again. I kept practicing and practicing. I moved my feet a little faster and a little faster until I could skate. And now I can skate as fast as my sister. Well, almost.
Boy, Diana sure can skate fast.
You call that fast?
Oh, slowly I turn, step by step. Hey, wait for me!
Whoa! And now, Elmo wants to find out Oh, there you are! Oh, Elmo wants to find out even more about fast and slow, don't you? How can we find out even more? Ooh, Elmo knows. We can watch the Fast and Slow channel on TV. On TV. Wow, that was fast. Turn yourself on TV. Thank you.
Welcome to the Fast and Slow channel, where we bring you fast and slow breaking news. And now the fast forward to our fast-paced yet slow-moving show, The Kingdom of Fast.
Once upon a time in the Kingdom of Fast, everything was fast. The sun rose and set very fast.
Rock-a-doodle-doo! Time to get up! Good morning!
Woo-hoo! Time to go to bed!
Good night!
Everyone in the Kingdom of Fast walked very fast, and they ate very fast, too.
Fast food again?
Then one day, the royal princess was having a royal play date with her friend Speedy. They were playing a quick game of royal ping pong. Play date's over.
Already? That was fast.
Time flies when you're having fun.
But we only got to ping. We didn't even get to pong. I want more time to play.
Whatever are we to do?
Think fast. The king and queen wrapped the royal brains. Just then, the royal snail came in.
You could slow down.
Slow down?
But this is the Kingdom of Fast.
So, you're the king and queen. Make it the Kingdom of Slow.
And from that day on, the Kingdom of Fast quickly became the Kingdom of Slow. Everything and everyone in the Kingdom of Fast slowed down. Everyone ate slowly and walked slowly. And the princess had a nice slow game of ping pong. And they all lived slowly ever after.
Stay tuned for Fast and Slow Times at Ridgemont College.
so long.
I stopped to smell the roses.
Always.
Oh, yeah. Elmo could ask the tortoise and the hare.
Ask us what?
Elmo wants to know more about fast and slow.
Sorry, don't have time to tell you.
I'll tell you our story. Once upon a time.
Tell it. He hasn't got all day. Once upon a time, there was a tortoise and a hare.
Look. Let's just imagine Elmo has a tortoise and a hare.
They ran a race to see who was faster.
Elmo hare will beat Elmo tortoise to the finish line. Huh.
We'll see about that.
Oh, your mark is set, go! Elmo hare will take a nap and still win the race.
He's going nowhere fast. Slow and steady, slow and steady.
But while the hare slept, the tortoise kept on going.
Slow and steady, slow and steady.
Just as the tortoise was crossing the finish line, the hare woke up.
Won by a hare.
And the moral of the story is, slow and steady wins the race.
How about this for a moral? You snooze, you lose. Hey, come back in again.
Quick, what did you think of our story?
Well, Elmo thought it was a little slow. And a little fast.
It was.
Elmo loves fast and slow. Oh, so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the fast and slow song.
Oh, can we sing it fast?
Sure.
And slow.
Of course.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy.
Piano. Oh, there you are. Now, here's a fast song and a slow song.
Ding-a-ling, ding-a-ling, do-do-do-do-do.
Fast and slow.
Say goodbye, Dorothy. Say goodbye, here.
Just a fast goodbye.
Oh, say goodbye, tortoise.
Goodbye.
Was brought to you today by the letter, I can't remember. Let's rethink the day. Oh, look, there it is. What letter is that?
M.
Right, M is the letter of the day. But what's today's number? There it is. What number?
Zero.
Right. Zero is the number of the day. So, Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter M and by the number zero. This is Murray saying see you next time on the street. Peace.